Another type of conditional statement that we have as a tool to us in Java is something called a switch statement. And a switch statement in my mind just relatively recently became much more useful than it was before. Switch statements are similar to if statements. They kind of provide the same function, but they do it in maybe a more convenient way depending on the situation. And so we'll create our program here, switchFun. And the switch statement works like this. We can set up a test. And so we can say switch, and we switch a certain variable that's going to hold some information. And so we look at that variable, and then from that variable, we will create various cases. And so we can say case, it's something. And so let's take a look, continuing on with my obsession about age, at some milestones in our lives. For a lot of us, at least here in America, 16 is a big milestone because that's the age in most states where you can get a driver's license. And so we can, let's go back and just create a, well, let me set it up a little bit. So let's do, we'll import the java.util.asterisk. And then I'll build my scanner. So scanner in equals new scanner system in. Okay. And then I'll get the age from the user. So I'll say system.out.println, please enter your age. Okay, I forgot to create a variable to hold it, so I'll just come up here and say, let's create an integer called age and set equal to 0. Okay, so how old are you? Or please enter your age, I guess is a nicer way of asking it. And I say, let's set that age equal to the in.next int is the type of information we're reading in, right? It's an integer. So we're going to get the age, and then we're going to print a comment based on the age. Okay, so we have some different cases here. So the variable that I'm going to look at is age. Okay, and then I'm going to make some, like I said, various cases. If they just turn 16, then, or if they are 16, then we can say so case 16. Then I come in below and say system.out.println, congratulations, you can drive. Now I realize it's not that age everywhere, but that's one scenario. What other ages are, let's do 21, system.out.println. If you're 21, then we'll say congratulations. You can gamble and lose your money. Okay, case. It was funny because there's, I don't know if it's still on, but there was kind of a electronics convention called Comdex down in Las Vegas, and it was told to me that generally they'll discount rooms to get people to stay at their hotels because they figure they're going to make their money back from them gambling, right? Well, what they found with the type of people that write computer programs, for the most part, is that because they're logical thinkers, right? Either they don't gamble because logically they know that the probability of them winning is very small, and they don't have the money to build those huge casinos for no reason, right? Was that a negative? That was like a not that I put in that statement. I don't know if that statement even made sense. You'll have to listen back and see if it made sense. But that so either they didn't gamble, or if they did gamble, they won a lot on a higher percentage. And so anyway, I thought that was kind of funny coming from a guy who, you know, analyzes everything and tries to think about things logically. What's another age? Well, at what age is it? At 25, you can finally rent a car, right? System.out.println. Congratulations. You can rent a car. That's very exciting. Is it 25 or 26? It might be 26. Is it 26? 25. I think it's 26, actually. Okay. Well, whatever it is. This isn't perfect. None of these examples are. But we'll go ahead and run this. And then I can give an age. Now, what's going to happen here is kind of interesting. If I say my age is 26, then it will say, congratulations, you can rent a car, because that's the case that matched the age. I'm looking at age using this switch statement, and the age matched up with this age 26, and so this is the statement that it prints. The interesting thing about switch statements, though, is let's say I enter the age 16, and it tells me, congratulations, you can drive, congratulations, you can gamble, and congratulations, you can rent a car. This was a very exciting 16th birthday. The problem is, in the switch statements, it, as you can see, once it hits a case that it matches, then it will execute everything below that. And so we have to include, after our scenario, what we call a break statement. A break statement says, whatever I'm in right now, so meaning the switch statement. Switch statements, you know, what we're in braces-wise, we're inside the switch statement. This break says break out of the if statement, or the switch statement, sorry. We can break out of an if statement too, or break out of a loop. We can break out of different things, but we generally try not to break out of stuff when we can help it. But in a switch statement, we need to use breaks. And so I'll break out of that statement, and then I'll break out of this statement. Okay, so each of these cases includes a break. And so if I run this now, and I say 16, then I only get that one statement, because after this statement executes, then we break out of that switch statement. And the advantage of that, by the way, is there are some situations where we might want to stack cases. So we can say case 15. Case 14. In Idaho, I think they can drive at 14. So if it's any of these cases, we can stack the cases together and then say if it's any of these cases, then we'll print this statement. And so there is a nice functionality to, I guess, needing the break, because sometimes we want to have various scenarios that lead to the same outcome, and we can stack those cases together. But let's try this again. Now if I say 21, then it says congratulations, you can gamble. Well, what if it's anything else? I mean, there's some exciting ages, but sometimes you just turn, you know, whatever, 22, and you say, wow, that was a really exciting age. So what can we do? Well, with switch statements, there's also a default. And so we can say, what's the default situation? We usually put this last. If none of the other cases, well, I guess it would only make sense to put it last. If none of the other cases line up, then we'll say something like, wow, boring age. Okay. So now, if I hit one of those ages, so if I say 21, it'll print out that message. But if I enter an age like I don't know, 26. Oh, that's the car rental. I forgot how exciting that age was. Wow. Sorry. I apologize. 28. Wow. Boring age. No huge milestone happening at that age. And so any of those ages, if I try another one, please enter your age, and I say 49. Wow, boring age. Because that's the default. That's kind of the else of this switch statement. Now, why did I say that I didn't find these that useful? Well, you can see that this can be done with an if statement, right? An if, else, if. I could say if age equals 16, print out this statement. Else, if age equals 21, print out this statement. Else, if age equals 26, print out that statement. Else, print out boring age. So we can accomplish this same thing in an if statement. Well, it used to be in Java that you couldn't switch a string. So you couldn't switch anything but numbers and characters. All right. And so they you know, relatively recently made that change to where you can now switch words, and the switch statement becomes a lot more useful because it becomes kind of a shorthand way of doing things. It's a lot easier to write out this case, whatever the number is, than to write if age equals whatever the age is. So those are switch statements, and we use those sometimes to conditionally execute code again. This is just another way of doing things, like the if statements. The switch statement is another way of conditionally executing code so that this statement will only be printed if it's the case that the age is 16 that I just entered. Okay, hopefully that makes sense. Spencer out.